It's Thursday, June 4th, 2015. And today we'll be hearing from Mr. Keshe, as we have for the last 63 Knowledge Seekers workshops. And also we hope to hear from Dan Winter in today's workshop. And I think we might hear from Mike as well. And who knows who else will be contributing to the festivities today. Okay, let's start off with the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute promotional video. This one has the English subtitles. Go ahead, Vince.
Where does humanity go from here? What have we tried to do? What if there is more, much more? The Keshe Foundation is proud to announce a new way to bring humanity forward through technology that brings humanity in line with the natural operation of the planet and universe itself. The new science and technology discovered and developed by the nuclear engineer Moran Keshe centers upon the use and control of magnetical gravitational fields. This new body of knowledge opens the road to hundreds of potential applications, which offer solutions to most of the fundamental problems of the world, such as water, food, environmental contamination, and shortages of energy. The Keshe Foundation is proud to unveil the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute. Nestled amidst the beautiful shores of Bari, Italy, the Institute is poised to become a central hub in the spreading of plasma technology and knowledge. With its state-of-the-art 21st century facilities, the Institute will be able to provide students and staff an immersive way to learn the plasma technology, to be the leaders of the new generation of scientists and plasma engineers. The Keshe Foundation has opened the door to the world for peaceful usage of technology that is independent of the limited resources that are available on Earth. This is an understanding of how everything works together in harmony in our universe, and it applies to everything from the smallest to the biggest, from atoms to galaxies. We all are able to collectively work together in pursuit of knowledge, innovation, and solutions for our society. This learning environment is new to the world, where there will be no test to confirm your understanding. The knowledge of everyone will be respected and allowed to flourish in a nurturing environment. Hands-on testing and experimenting will be widely used in conjunction with roundtable discussions to bring all opinions and knowledge forward. Students will be introduced to a change in the ethos of working in collaboration. Students will experience firsthand how we share knowledge in a free and open manner. Graduating students are expected to share the knowledge they gain from the university within their respective communities and nations. All formal teachings, lectures, and presentations will be in the English language, with technology available for immediate translation. Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute will be offering 3-year executive master programs for undergraduate degree students and 1-year executive master programs for graduate degree students in the following fields: space transportation, new plasma technology, health, agriculture, materials, energy. The health section is designed to make students able to live in space without the need to return to Earth. To this end, the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute has found processes for many diseases, including ALS, cancer, coma, epilepsy, multiple sclerosis. Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute will offer online teaching courses which will enable anyone, anywhere around the world to enroll and increase their knowledge and understanding. Students will have the opportunity to direct their work towards commercial spin-offs and seek funding through the help of the Keshe Foundation. The access to the new science and new technologies is openly available for peaceful use to the benefit of mankind to make a better world today. Now you can be part of the changing world and the new knowledge. All commercial spin-offs are intended to be open source and patent free. This is part of the core ethos of the Keshe Foundation and the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute. Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute will have its official inauguration on April 21st, 2015, with courses commencing soon after on May 4th, 2015. The students of the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute will be the leaders of the future who will make changes in all areas of space technology, science, medicine, agriculture, and energy. Anyone is able to apply, but acceptance is through invitation only. No prerequisites are required. We will be accepting approximately 250 students for the 3-year Executive Master's Program and 120 students for the 1-year Executive Master's Program. We welcome humanity's participation in the knowledge of the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute. Where does humanity go from here? That is up to you. Apply today.
Okay, that was the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute promotional video, and now we'll move along to the main part of the workshop, and I think first we'll hear from Mr. Keshe, if things are okay at that end, and he can fill us in on what the latest news is, and we'll progress into hearing from some of our guests and so on in the workshop. Mr. Keshe, are you there?
Yes, good morning. Good day. I see
some fine tuning going on with Marco there.
Yeah, he knows everything. I'm a, as I said, jack in the box. I pop out, I do my work and disappear. He does everything in the background. Good morning, good day to you. As usual, as we said, this is a 64th workshop that we are holding. Our tradition has been that on Thursdays, now that we open the institute, we allow others to look in and still the same process, and on, as we do on Tuesday afternoons. We keep, when we go on holidays, you have to remember, we keep the Thursday morning sessions open. It means even during the summer holidays, Christmas holidays, even though we don't teach, but Thursday's teachings or workshops stays open. But Tuesdays we close because there was some confusion this week with national holidays, what we call the Whitsun is held in south of Italy this week, where most of the Europe had it last week. So we had to close 2 days, the university is totally closed, shut down. So it doesn't matter, open or closed, any Thursday, we held it on the New Year's and Christmas this year. So we keep Thursday mornings always open as long as we can and as long as the foundation and people around the foundation are active. On the other hand, there is an important announcement or correction to be done. Last week, we sent the road, the peace roadmap to be posted on the foundation forum, and I don't understand, somehow got muddled up, the wrong one has gone up, and on Saturday or Sunday, I just happened to look, I don't usually look at the website, and I noticed it's the wrong paper altogether, there's a lot of mistakes in it, this is not what we sent to be published. And the strangest thing is they put a peace flag on it as well, which was the biggest embarrassment to me. I don't believe in that man with two legs, what they call this peace sign. It never served anything except the ones who wanted to make money out of it. So what we've done, the correct one has been loaded now. We apologize for it. Most probably a lot of you had a good laugh with it because some part of it wasn't really correct. The correct one is loaded. There is something for the future for you to understand. Any paper which is published, any book which is published, anything released by me or the foundation on my behalf, which I have sent out past 10, 15 years, all been signed What this means, nobody can say in the future, this is what Cash says. This is the original one which was sent to be published. And what you see on all my papers, a signature at the bottom, initial, and all the papers are closed at the end with a private signature of mine on it. So if you do not see a copy exactly as it's signed by me, it's not done by me. So this original one was kept and is there, and is signed on a private signature. And these documents, all my papers till a few years ago, have been lodged and secured with a notary, which means the totality of the integrity of the papers, the patents, everything, I think is two lots of 700 pages of documents, which page by page has been initialed by me and the notary over day, 2 days, 3 days. That means the papers are the original papers. So what was published last week, I don't know how it happened, is not what was sent to be published, but hopefully it doesn't happen again. The road peace map, if you send it out, please resend it again. And I do apologize for if such a thing has happened, and hopefully will not happen again. On the other hand, the road peace map we keep to our target. I thank Marco and Arvin and the others who ran the workshop last week, as I was attending it. I had to be in a meeting in Rome last Thursday. It was appointed to meet one of the world leaders and one of the most powerful men, which I have a lot of respect for, but unfortunately he was ill. In the coming time, we'll meet again in the next few days when he recovers. And this is his work, and my work is very much is on the peace plan. You all of them knowing he's one of the men, I adored his work for years, and he is one of the most powerful politicians in the world today. His line of thinking is the same as me, and I told Marco that I had to attend this meeting in Rome. And meanwhile, I met with other officials, and they all have seen a World Peace Treaty. The roadmap is very clear. In the coming weeks and months, we will go through the governments, the people, the contacts, and the officials we have in our portfolio of friends and colleagues, and some of them business colleagues, which now become leaders in their own right. And in so many ways, the roadmap, the peace roadmap, is the ultimate goal. There is something which I discussed yesterday with the knowledge seekers here, which we'll go through it later on, hopefully on time, and we'll explain exactly what we are planning to do. The integrity of world peace comes according to what you do personally. How you get it put out, how you match the road map and the document of the peace treaty that you sign yourself into has to go together. This has caused a very big problem for a number of world leaders in the past week, past 2 weeks. You got to understand, we have access to different governments in different ways, and it's the first time I've been told the political scene, diplomatic scene, and military scene has no objection to the peace roadmap. What this means, it means the world leaders think it will not happen, so they don't object it. The military think it as a laughing stock, they will not consider it can be done, because they'll have no position as military heads. And the politicians see it as a point that they can score in respect to the other colleagues that are for the peace. So what I've said in the teachings of past few days here in the institute, if you are a student as a knowledge seeker, and to the people around who I speak to in the diplomatic side and the political side and the military, is that you take your time. We share the patterns, we share the knowledge, and now we enforce the knowledge. So it is going to be the effort of the Collective Keshe Foundation, if you are here to serve peace and not your pocket. And if, as I said to somebody past few days, if your target is peace and you, this is what you're attending and you're hoping to get, don't wait for 21st of June. Allocate half an hour a day to send the world peace message to as many people as possible all the time. Half an hour a day. Make peace part of your work, part of your life. 10 minutes a day. Doesn't matter who you send it to, how many other people you can put it, how many websites you can put it on. Let it be seen. Then we show our way. The position is very clear. The government will not act because with it there will be no government. They will not be in the position. The religious leaders will not act because once there is a peace and man understand there is no need for path of going to a house to pray where in a space there are no houses to pray to, they have no position. So they are fighting their position. This way goes back to a lot of you, hundreds of thousands of you. I received thousands and thousands of emails. I betrayed humanity. I'm another one of the Illuminatis. I'm another crook in the pack. When I gave the key to the USB stick of patterns to the world government. And then when you received it, nothing. That's all it was. You got what you were stealing, you were hoping to steal, because you thought it was stolen from you. This time around, if you do not push for the world peace, it's only you who can blame yourself for what you have left out. If the target is world peace, if the target is to achieve world peace through technology, this is most probably one of the only chances. We've seen organizations like Greenpeace talking activists. They don't have anything to substitute. With the Keshe Foundation, not only we have to substitute, we have the facilities to replace, that it guarantees jobs in a correct way. I was talking to Soheil yesterday, Armin is on his way, we most probably see him this morning before we finish. You'll come to understand the Keshe Foundation, the structure and the people who work in the background in collaboration to bring things out are setting factories up to make sure we are not in the hand of others, but the Keshe Foundation as a family stays in charge of the release of the technology and development. So Mr. Hoy and Soheil are setting up not only the research lab structure in China, but the structure of the manufacturing of the equipment by the foundation has started taking place this week, thanks to Armin, which is always coming back. He'll most probably fill us in more detail if need be. So not only we teach, now we are implementing, and the third step, we got into distributing the knowledge in a working condition. Then there is one point. In the teachings of yesterday, I explained something very straightforward. And this teaching will go back further for the people who are not in their classrooms, in a way to understand what is about to happen. As I said, we gave documents to the government. We gave keys to the nations. We gave, released the keys, the USB stick to public. And in the past 4 weeks, we start teaching extensively in one direction, to achieve lift and motion and energy directly by public and not by the Keshe Foundation. Every way possible, I'm opening doors of teaching. And in Friday teachings, I mentioned one thing which I emphasized on it yesterday. And that is, my mission is accomplished. I've delivered what I came here to do. Now I have to see it through. What does this mean? It means most of the knowledge needed for you to achieve lift, motion, energy, food, the structure of the security and defense in the space, and materials, and the medical part, is all being delivered. So now we enter, as of now, that we pushed for the world peace, in the direction and in the phase which has never been known, and we never disclosed what we spoke about. I explained this yesterday to the knowledge seekers. And that is, excuse me, the cameraman. That is, we have taught in the past years the knowledge. Now we brought you as knowledge seekers. But all of you, according to your ethos of teaching, when you have a knowledge and your thought, you want to see a practicality, or somebody can show you a test run. The target of the Keshe Foundation originally has been and stayed the same, that we are teaching for two purposes. One is for peace, and the consequence of it, to take man into space, to join the man into the universal family. Man has been, as I said, in its village of Earth, and now for it to go to universal community, as is tradition, family help to bring a child up into the society. We have taught the child. We have given everything we can. Consequence of it will be peace. And as of this month, as we shown yesterday and in the past few days, we start opening that the man of space will teach the man of earth the way to become part of the universal family. So from now on, you will not see explanation or definition or systems or testing so much by me, but we bring technology from space taught, shown by man of space. This is the breakthrough. This is what we're going to tell and what we're going to teach and what we're going to show. So, as I said, my mission is complete. I've done what I accepted to do. Some of you have accepted to do the same, to teach more. And now you say, show me, then I believe it. I don't do the showing. The showing will be done. I've done enough of it. Showing will be done by the knowledge seekers, and we will show the space development by man of space. So what this means, you will see events, you will see conditions, you will see unknown conditions, or you will see conditions which you know but you cannot put together, and we elaborate on it. We sometimes give you notice in advance of it, and sometimes you will see it as it happens. So from now on, not only we speak about space technology and peace, we start showing the delivery of the knowledge of the space by man of the space, or what you like to call aliens. So from now on, you will see events in a space in horizon, on land. I've been telling you for months that we can make an environment in the lab where we bring what we call the aquarium of the universe, that we can show you your bigger family of space. Now we are ready. Number of events has been taking place. Step by step, we are trying to bring you to understand it. And we released a small video yesterday, and I have received a second video from another Italian who's been present on the events, how these events, why is significant. We explained in the teaching that in one sweep, in the past, more or less since Saturday, Sunday, and it was done before, and it'll been done before, but this time we explain it, is how we're going to paralyze the defense technology of all the governments in one go. If the peace is not accepted and delivered. We delivered the patterns, nobody could believe it'll be done. We shown the reactors openly, nobody ever teaches that way. But now, instead of you are trying to do what you don't understand, there is no way I'm going to attempt to do it anymore, because four times trying to be killed is enough. Now we bring you the man of space. The agreement is, in the coming months, on appointed time and days, we announce events in advance. Contact points, teaching points, system delivery, showing of technology. In the coming next 12 months, 18 months, we organize and pre-plan demonstrations by what you like to call UFOs, or what we call universal spaceships. This is a big claim, but when you see it one by one, you'll understand exactly how it's done, how we do it, how we deliver it, and then you understand a very big question. Do we need governments, or do we share directly with people? Number of negotiations with number of governments with this structure has failed. Now we deliver direct to the public. It's you who has to decide what you're going to do with it, how you're going to do with it, how you're going to deal with it, and to be honest, you have no choice. Read this very carefully. You have no choice but to walk the path of peace. I've explained in a number of ways, different ways. A lot of you have been blind to it because you don't understand the technology. And some of you have understood. We deliver technologies which will not only advance man very rapidly to the point of peace, but we take the element of war out of the arsenal of the man's life. So you will not even think about the war, you will not even understand the war. So my shout and my call goes to world leaders. We know a number of them, and their officials listen to these teachings quite regularly, and that is, start a peace talk, or we bring peace through demonstration of the units, which bring even the president don't remember why they are president. Very simple. This technology will harm no one, will not kill no one. It's not a terrorist organization, it's a scientific, universal time to rejoin the family of the universe. So, as we said, terrorist organizations, people will not even remember why they're carrying arms. At the same time, we can create a condition that the presidents and kings do not even remember why they are and who they are as a king and a president. So we solve the solution in two ways. Take the idiots out, and they take the ones who think they're idiots out too. So the knowledge is very simple, and your weakest point is your amino acid. And the king and the terrorist, what they call terrorists temporarily to suit them, share in common. The same animal. Don't forget, something very interesting, which a lot of you don't know, but it's good because it's taken out of your memory in a short time, is terrorists established the state of Israel. And then they became the presidents, and then they became Nobel Prize winners. So if you're a terrorist, you can become a Nobel Prize winner. Depends who accepts you as a terrorist, who accepts you as a leader. This is the difference. If you look, all the terrorist leaders became the world leaders, and then they've been given a Nobel Prize. So we're dealing with a bunch of Nobel Prize terrorists. This is the structure. This has got to stop. This will stop. And in so many ways, we've shown the way. In so many ways, you as public will carry it out. Very simple. Put your blood into the GANS reactors. You connect to anyone. Don't forget the structure of the free plasma is made by the GANS materials within the reactor. Your blood with CO2 creates a GANS-based center which is connected to every being on this planet. Common denominator. Free plasma touches the emotion and the soul of the man. But you don't know how to touch the soul. But with this, you can touch the man. So, terrorist, or in other name, international terrorists as kings and presidents, their job is finished. So, the peace has to come through understanding that terrorists become the presidents, and the presidents also of them become terrorists. Depends which way they elevate. We've seen, even in Libya today, the president of Libya used to be a terrorist. Now he's been appointed by the British as a president, because they can do whatever they like because he works for them. So, we see that clearly with Yasser Arafat. The biggest terrorist God ever known, he became a Nobel Prize winner and became head of Palestinians. No man has created more death than Yasser Arafat. If I tell you the story of the man, you will walk off. The same with Sharon. The same, go back to a number of world leaders. Look at the structure, how terrorists became world leaders, given Nobel Prize. This is a confirmation of you're one of us, you're one of the murderers. Then you go. Most of the American presidents, they become president, one way or another, they get a Nobel Prize, because they guarantee the cycle of terror. This is what has to stop. I've been very soft, very smooth with the whole structure, but now it's not in my hand. I get killed, anything happens to me, mix your blood. Get blood from three different races, from three different color of man, black, white, and Middle Eastern. You reach any man on this planet you like. But you have to find the three which they love each other. Black is the origin of the creation. Middle East is the division. And white is the end product. You have the origin, you have the division, you have the end products. You cover all the DNAs in RNA. Mix them in your ganses, you control the macro. Now, how much more you want to push, how much more you want to stop, it all depends on you. How are we going to use the workshops, not to teach you how to make reactors, but to show you now the reactors you made are copy of yourselves. Copy of your emotion, copy of your soul, copy of, if you know how to do, to change your physicality through the reactors. You took the matter, and out of the matter, as I always said and you all know, you created the free plasma. You use the free plasma with another free plasma, which is your thoughts, what you want to dictate, put the blood of man into it, you can make a man with 10 legs, 20 arms. Because now you touch the emotion according to what you want and the physicality responds. An old English say, what is good for geese is good for the gander. What is good for the male duck is good for the female duck too. You can go up, you can go down. You find a way. Because in a space, you need to do this because it's the easiest way to adapt into the environment. When you go with the body of a man into deep space, for you to adapt to the new environment takes millions of years. You put the emotion, the soul of the man, the physical brain of the man, it adapts itself to it automatically. Immediate solution in a space. So it goes back what we can show, how we can show, and I've given a few warnings in the past few months. Now we gave a clear warning yesterday. And as I said, we will light the stars and we will make the whole earth a daylight, day and night to celebrate when the man accepts peace. We have shown a number of ways of doing this, and in the coming weeks and months, you will show us how to achieve this. If you do not push for the peace, we will use the structure. This is not the first time it's been done. If need be, we can do. Roadmap for peace is one direction only, and no mercy. And as written on it, there is no alternative. There is no choice. Yesterday in the teachings, as we spoke, you know how to make GANs. You know how the matter works. You know how the plasma works. And you learn how to work with gases. And a mixture of four in any of these reactors, you decide. You have, you create the condition through it. You create the matter through its plasma, which is the free plasma. Then you create the gases, which in the GANs state can convert to physicality of anything anywhere in the universe. So, if you understand this, and you understand the totality of the science of the universe, the big question for you is, how many others are amongst us who have mutated to be like us?
Mr. Keshe?
Alone on this planet? Or have we become part of what we did not know, but they're among us? The answer is very simple. They've been among us for a long, long time. Pardon?
I just had a quick question here on live stream. It related to what you were talking about there. And the question was, how can you avoid people to use this in a harmful way?
To use it in what?
A harmful way.
That's your choice. You choose. The ball is in your hand. You run with it, explain it, and let them choose. I tell you who's going to start the biggest defense. The biggest defense and opposition will come directly from one place and one place only. And that is from the religious leaders. The religious leaders will object because they have no more status. The attacks on the foundation will come from Vatican, Islamic State, and the others. Because when you accept world peace on equality of the promise of the blessed name Christ, is there a need for someone to tell you what is right or wrong? No. So there is no position for the Pope. We have written the position of the Pope up anyway. It's gone, it's finished. It's just a puppet figure for a very short while. The same with the Islamic leaders. The same with Jewish leaders and the others around the world under the different name of worship and belief. Because none of them have delivered what they came and was the promise of the prophets or the leaders. So they will object because I'm a Satan, whatever they like to call, because if they accept peace, there is no Vatican. Then there is two questions to ask. Is the self-interest of Pope worth millions dying for? One man or a very few man to keep their position, the rest of the humanity to pay for it. I say no. Why should a few people have a luxury of being called the Pope, Ayatollah, Rabbi, and the rest of it? This is a fight I've had for years with my family. I come from a very peculiar background. From my grandfather, from father's side, I'm a Sayyid. Which means I'm descended directly from Muhammad. From my Jewish side of family, I'm Kohen. Which means I descend directly from Moses. My grandfather, my grandmother is a Kohen. I'm not allowed to attend a funeral because the blood of Moses cannot see the dead body. Anytime I attend a funeral, I'm asked to leave. So, did any of them sacrifice their life for a bunch of people to stop the development of the man? It's not worth it. So, they have to oppose. They have no more jobs. Where do the priests go to rob the soul of the man from anymore? Or rape a child? And the same with the others. So, we have one choice. We accept peace in a direct way. We negotiate peace. Who can get to it faster? Or we enforce peace that the two bunch of hooligans who've been threatening and doing whatever they like, the terrorists and the leaders do not even remember which one they are. Do we need world leaders? Where we have the most beautiful tool of peace, you can spend your time, number of knowledge seekers around the world, thousands of Keshe Foundation supporters around the world are making reactors, are making nanomaterials, are making energy units, and the rest of it. To make sure they are independent of the abuse of this bunch of hooligans. And the strange thing enough is in the front they fight. In the back they work together. Because one guarantees the position of the other. If you want me to tell you one of the biggest jobs set up to the terrorists and the religious leaders between the Vatican, the, what do you call, the rabbis and the ayatollahs, you'll walk out. And the cost to humanity, at least 10 million lives. Who says any of these have a right to kill 10 million people? And all this in past 35 years. And not before. Forget about what they've done before. In the past 10 years, the connection between the terrorists and the world leaders and religious leaders has caused that much death. Who gives them the right? Millions in Iran. Millions. We don't know how many million. Children of 7 years old, 5 years old, were given a plastic key to walk on the mines, that they go to heaven, that was the key to the heaven. Who knows? Have you ever been told? The Vatican bought 9 million landmines as a gift to Saddam Hussein, paid to the Italian government to be mined the border between Iran and Iraq during the war. Iran didn't have the facility to overcome the mines. Ayatollah Khamenei ordered to make a green plastic key, force children out of a school, give them a key, march them over the landmines. Thousands, hundreds of thousands of Iranian children died to overcome what the Pope initiated in Rome. To see that Islam doesn't come up, that the position of Vatican doesn't get endangered. We paid with our lives, with our children. Vatican got richer. And Ayatollah Khamenei got this position. There is a big revolution that's coming in Iran, is that the Sepah does not accept the religious side, because they said during the war, none of your children went to walk over the mine. Our children did. We decide the future of the government. The minute Ayatollah Khamenei, His Holiness, dies, Iran will divide into between Sepah and Ayatollahs. The power sits with the Sepah. And these are the people who sacrificed their children to walk over the mines, which Vatican paid to the Italian government to deliver the old mines from the Second World War to Saddam to protect it. And then when he did his job, they went and they destroyed it. Another million, 2 million children. Which religious leader has the right to initiate millions of children's death from Vatican? Is Vatican a religious organization, or is it a terrorist organization? To me and the rest of Islamic world, is a terrorist organization. But the funny thing is, nobody came to help Iran during this war. Who came to help Iran? Who brought arms to Iran to defend themselves against support of the West, Vatican, and Americans supporting Saddam? No one did, except one. This is going to shock a lot of you. The State of Israel. No one helped Iran during the killing of the children except the State of Israel by delivering arms directly into Tehran. Direct flight, Tel Aviv, Tehran. Track recorded to South America, Argentina. The Jewish boys of Iran supported Iran to protect Iran from the hand of Vatican. And strange enough, who brought the help and the guns from Israel to Iran? When the revolution happened, go on the television, watch the history. The day after Ayatollah Khomeini arrived in Tehran, private jet brought Mr. Yasser Arafat to Iran. Murdered as many Iranians as he could by contract. He got $1 per barrel per day to help the Palestinians to start the state of Palestine. Israelis and Americans were watching how they're buying arms. Mr. Yasser Arafat put 70% of income from Iran oil and the blood of Iranians who he killed into Swiss banks. And what happened? The arms all went to Middle East, to Israel, to be turned over by the Palestinians. Israelis knew the position. They captured the arms from the Palestinians, which Iran paid for, to Yasser Arafat, the terrorist, who became Nobel Prize winner. And then sold the second time the arms captured in Beirut to Tehran to support Iran against Saddam Hussein. Iran paid twice for the same arm. One, for killing his own people, second time, to kill his own children, on the name of Islam. So you see how three religions in the background work together. And how the Americans, all these are documented. Nothing is fairy tale. Cost to Iran, Middle East, 10 million lives in past 35 years. Now we want to talk about peace. Let's talk about the truth about the peace. The same plan by Vatican was set for Ukraine to take over the Russian church. They brought through Ireland the Queen of England under submission by blowing everything up that she gave the right of the, what you call, Church of England, Protestants and Catholics, to Vatican. By submission, by bombing literally England to the smithereens. And if you want to see documents, what they've done, I've got all of them here in Italy. They're with me. How I negotiated for peace in Ireland to be achieved. But the guys who are supposed to be religious leaders and the rest. Document page by page I release. Name, how I delivered, who took the money, what I took for peace. And I achieved it with collaboration of a number of people in England. I have black and white because I was part of the Northern Ireland Peace Organization. They trusted the man outside to do theirs because he was dispensable. But they never found out the man kept all the records. How Ian Paisley got paid, how Belfast leader, we know who he is, Jerry Adam got paid in Swiss banks. How we stopped all the financial affairs in Northern Ireland according pre-planned, I received all of it. Those in Northern Ireland know what I'm talking about. Talk about the fuel tanks, talk about the cars, drug trafficking, diamond deposited in Jersey. We have all of it. So you want to push for peace, I open the file of the world leaders. Go back. Clinton can tell you. He walked down the road. By accident, Jerry Adam comes out of bakery. They shook hands. That it means we accept the peace with Vatican. These are news reads. When I agreed, I accept. The last part, the shake hand took place. For 300 years, they could not come to do it the decent way. I control the finances of it. I show bank account, I show details page by page, who, what, where it was done. And all the documents have been shipped to Italy. For my protection, you touch me, I release. The same thing was done with Ukraine. Russian church is extremely wealthy and powerful. Vatican wants to be the world leaders of the Christians by murder, any task. And His Excellency Putin stood the ground. Bank of Russia, Central Bank of Russia, that's why all the boycotts go to the Bank of Russia if you see what happened in Ukraine. All done to empty literally the central bank and bring Church of Russia under the control of Vatican. And it didn't happen. It's a huge change. We prayed for it. We gave our souls as a core because we taken the leadership, and it will happen. I went online. The core members can tell you. I said, you give your soul to Putin because he's correct. And we saw it happen. So if world leaders, you think they are gentle people, they are not nothing terrorists. So your peace is in your hand, not in the hand of churches or world leaders. And if you want, I can give you more. I sat and I counted the gold bars which the Philippine president took out while he was leaving and was allowed to take out as long as he shared some of it with Vatican. Marcos. I sat in the basement of a building, center of London, watching how gold bars came out and how it was a split, what was negotiated to go. So world leaders have two choices. We push for peace or we open the books. The same goes how the state of Israel was established. All the guys who established the state of Israel, one by one, became the president of Israel. All the terrorists. How much they murdered in Palestine till they submitted British today. Go back the first 25 years of the state of Israel. Don't forget, we call it the state of Israel. We call everything else a government. Egyptian government. We call it Libyan government. We call it Iranian. We call it American government. We call it American nation. We call it Iranian nations. Saudi Arabian nation. Why do we call the state of Israel as a state of Israel? Because it's the 52nd state of the United States. Offshore. Protected as part of the nation. That's why nobody can touch you. You call it state of Texas, state of California, state of Israel. You have Hawaii offshore, nothing to do with the United States. You're negotiating for Tikva, state of Israel, 52nd state of the United States. That's why nobody understands why America supports Israel in every motion in the United Nations. Of course it does. It's part of its state. You're a Jewish state owned by the Kingdom of United Kingdom by proxy. So the world leaders speak peace or we open the books. I told you everything is recorded. For months, I told him, we open a book. We talk peace on the international level, stop all the wars. Or, I told you, I stepped, unfortunately, in too many presidents' bed. I know, too many secrets. So, now you explain. We gave the key the world leaders and the governments, they didn't give it to you. We gave it to you freely. You did nothing with it because you didn't know. Now you know what to do with it. Now it's you who's got to act for the peace, the respect of your governments. Otherwise, you never achieve it. Notice how they organize you. The terrorist organization and terrorist state changes according to what Vatican sees befits him in the West. Russians and Chinese and Japanese don't even report it because it's irrelevant. This is what they call in these states little children playing their little game. While the Europe was robbing Africa, while they were making all the wars to scrub the central banks, be it Libya, be it Iraq, it finished. It was temporarily They took some. But the real winner of all these wars in past 35 years is one nation, China. I have a lot of respect for this country and its leaders. I've been in touch, I've worked amongst them, and I have a huge respect for them. Because while they were busy robbing central banks, Chinese went to Africa and other nations, they developed their bases, they took the ingredients, paid for the market value, they established themselves. By the time they come back to find out what's happened, they could rob once the central bank. Now they control the whole nation on a fair basis. So, we have two choices. World leaders start talking about peace and spending money on peace, or it comes to one point. Do we need world religious leaders to rob us, kill us, and then terrorize us as a human race to fit their own seat? I said something a few months ago. The marbles and the stones of Vatican have to go back where they came from. Colosseum. It's the habit. They built the building from stealing from another place, and it's become the habit of them. They stole the physicality by lions, and they stole the soul by the name of popes. The same with every other religion. I give you one by one. Strange. I explained to you, I come from background of two, Jewish and Muslim. My family eat in our house on the same table. No discussion. They love each other. Doesn't matter, one is Jewish, one is Muslim. My Jewish family, when they came to Manchester, we couldn't find a kosher meat. Halal is the same. Can we go to halal? We used to buy them halal meat. So there is no difference between the path of belief. It just, we choose it when it suits us. So the world leaders have two choices. Now the reactors are running. Now we teach the process. Now we don't accept the man to do it on his own, because he needs to get confidence that there is somebody to support it if it goes wrong, and it shows the path. You want to see, I explained this yesterday in teaching, and it's happened a few times. We explained the process. It was shown openly on Sunday in Italy. Vince, can you show the video? And I explained to you the whole process, please, what we showed yesterday.
Sure, just let me unmute my mic. Can you hear me, Mr. Keshe?
Yes, I can hear you clearly.
Oh, thank God. Okay. Finally.
Finally. Open the video and let it be seen. And then I explain what we're going to do with you with what you see.
Okay, just give me and one sec here.
Pardon?
I'm just, give me one sec. I'll show the video and put it on live stream as well.
I told you there's no mercy with what we started.
Do you want the audio as well?
Everything, the full caboodle.
Okay.
How do we get this out of the way? We need the screen, please, on the top.
I'll wait for you before I turn my microphone over and start the video.
We are ready. It's just that. Okay.
Okay, I'll mute you and play the video.
Okay.
Okay. This is now, what's the time?
Quarter to one.
This has been on top of us for nearly 3 hours, over 3 hours now. This is what I explain when you can make a cloud to look like a cloud, but you hide behind it. The whole horizon has changed, the clouds have changed. We saw before, remember the video where you could see an airline flying through it? two helicopters that have been trying to find out what it is. They've gone very high altitude, but they still sit here. And they'll be here as long as I'm open and close. You see, it's a beautiful, beautiful horizon under sea, under sea level, and it comes to it. It'll be in here. Everything has changed. This is what I call a full UFO cover. Sits in the horizon of the sun. The central is the sun, so you can't see it. But you can identify the circle of it. So by naked eye, we consider UFO sitting, or what you call the spaceship, sitting in the middle. And it's blinding. So it uses this light of the sun to stay over us for another 3-4 hours. This will not be repeated. It's a wish, as I said, our wishes are common. And you will see more and more and more and more of these things around us. It's time to change. The center is where the spaceship sits. And this is what I explained 3 days ago in teaching, creating cloud condition. The horizon, you see, and then you go to it. It's absolutely perfect. This will not repeat when we ask French for the power of the knowledge that you can understand. Lamppost, the edge, and you can see the whole circle. The UFO, what you call spaceship, sits right in the sun, so you cannot see it. And that's how you cover yourself. In the eye of the man, you're on the horizon, and that's parallel. You can see it, you're both figuring the same thing. Today is now about 1 o'clock, 31st of May. Same position, just covering the sunlight.
Us to show. As I said, nothing was said. There are Italians who have taken the same video as us. Would you like to go on the full screen? And they will release it, I'll receive it, that you can see from different angles. So the position is very simple. What you see is what we thought before. We sit here prior to establishment of the full circle. Italian helicopter at high altitude flies because the Italian radar system military, which is just about 20 kilometers, this is the radar center, was used when it was a communist time. The most powerful radars sit on the border between, on the coast of Italy with Albania and the other side. They flew a second one. They could not do anything. A second, a jetliner, with radar goes through it to establish what it is. The time of the duration, about 4 hours. No cloud, start formation of the cloud to disappear, and it kept on the same position all the time. I've explained in the teaching yesterday how it's done. In fact, from sitting here, that's the atmosphere. The spaceship is outside, creates a condition of 2 to 4 kilometers diameter horizon shielding. If you look at it, it's that way. If you look at it from the bottom, which we look, is there. The center, you think, sits with the sun, but you actually see the spaceship in the horizon of the sun, you cannot see because it's the same intensity. The sun sits here. We explain these kind of shadows in the teaching with the needle and the shadow of the GANS and the material color. Darkness, you see, is a full sphere, full shape of the spaceship. system. Magnetic shielding, no interaction, using the GANS material of upper atmosphere of the nitrogen. What would you like it to be? In the coming time, these will become the light in the sky, where I said we lit the earth instead of the dark light, we change it to a light and you see. The interaction between the man and the universal community has started. You have no choice. We dictate the condition. We move this up. We touch the satellite ring. We touch it further. We touch the military satellite rings, paralyzing all military communication instantaneously, as long as we decide. But if we do this, the world leaders will find out that terrorists will take the field day, because they can do whatever they like. There is no government to stop them. People like Yasser Arafat, who are now have different names, with the same bosses, will have a field day. But I have bad news for you guys. We can create the gravitational magnetic field, the amino acid, of the both terrorist groups, the presidential and the one on the ground which they fight. So you have two choices. Bring it in yourself or reinforce it on you. But when we switch this off, you go back becoming animals. If you do it yourself, accept peace, you stay with it. That's the difference. I told you 21st of June, 21st of July, 21st of August, to start making peace. Otherwise, we know how to enforce it. We don't do it. So many times, 4 or 5 times, I said to you a simple thing. Planning, where we are today. And I said, if you think we were here by accident, you got a long way coming. You're Italian. What is Trani known for? Put the microphone to him, please. That's your microphone.
Praticamente Trani è conosciuto perché da qui.
Not in Italian, in English.
Okay.
What is Trani known for?
Trani is known because from this place started the first crusade from.
The Crusaders. From,
yes.
To Trani Jerusalem. Is known for Crusaders for freeing Jerusalem.
Yes.
That's why we are here. But our Jerusalem is planet Earth and humanity. One planet, one nation. And we don't need to kill, we deliver our technology. You cannot kill each other because it has a safety key factor. And because you don't have the knowledge, you don't know where we put the key. No man shall be killed, no man shall be harmed by the technology. But men can harm themselves. We don't. You can kill yourself, but I won't kill you. Because when you kill yourself, you commit suicide. You're stupid. If I kill you, I become a murderer, I have to pay for your soul. So I know the game. So we go back on one point, and this goes, send a copy of this teaching today to every world religious and priest and imam and ayatollah around the world. But the most beautiful thing is, who gave life to this technology to come out in the cradle of itself, according as it happened with Moses? Who brought Moses up? The king who was afraid that will take his kingdom. Yeah? We all know that. who brought this technology up? In the cradle of Islamic Republic of Iran, by the religious people, trend of the religions. The term of Ayatollah Khamenei in the Islamic Republic as Islamic nation, as leadership of Islamic nation, is finished. Like the Pope, like the rabbis, like every other religion. Because now Ayatollahs, Imams, priests, popes are all human, equal, and loving each other. So instead of having different names to worship me, I worship myself in my name. No need to fight, because, as is written on the paper, in my name. Because my name means love, that's what is called Ihram. Affection, love, kindness. So, you have two choices. Cut all the rubbish out in different names to line your pockets, or the people will do it for you. Do it amicably, without any fight. Call that the end of religion game has come. We work as one race, one nation. All the government leadership's name changes instead of the communist, democrat, liberals, or whatever you want to call it. The kings and the rest, equal, we go into space and we accept the terms and the conditions of the universal community, which is peace and equality. You have no choice, because millions of people now know how to make guns, and they know how to travel into space, and with the knowledge they've gained, and they gain more of, they'll be able to communicate, to live amongst the man of space without the need of the animalness of the earth. So, we push for peace. I showed you the technology. How you do it is very simple. Go on the teaching of the Keshe Foundation of yesterday in respect to motion and matter. I've gone through it in detail. You make yourself a system, and you tell your king, your president, your government, I'm not killing, and I don't pay taxes to you to kill in my name. To run a government without war expenditure is 20% taxes. You take military expenditure out of any government to run a decent healthcare, a decent educational system, a decent lifestyle needs 20% taxes and no more. Because politicians won't rob anymore. That's 5% of your taxes, paying thieves. Civil servants, you don't need to back up. You look at in front 2-3% military expenditure per GDP, but I've been looking with the governments in the papers. In reality, it's 15%, because it creates employment on a different day. So that was 20%. That's 40% taxes. You stand to your government, I do not do any black, I do not do anything in the back pocket, I earn a penny, I earn a pound, I earn a euro, you don't need to come to me, I put my 20% in the bank of the government for you to teach, for you to educate, for you to bring your health care. This way, at the moment, the governments, what do? they tax you out of the 100 euro, every 100 euro you earn, they take 65 to 70% of it under different name of taxation. So, in fact, what you're left with is 30 to 35% of your hard work. You're not prepared to do that. Because, don't forget, 5% to 10% of national income goes on the ones who are working but not paying tax, and the government pays them to stay home. So what they do, they earn their money in black, and then you pay them on top. So there it goes, more money towards your coffer. 20% and another 10, that's 50%. So when people don't lie, when people can't steal, so you don't have to pay 35%, take home 30% of your hard work. Now, if it's fair, I keep 80%. I like the road to be clean. I don't need a police force as such. And secondly, there is no national army. How come we don't have a national army between 29 nations in Europe? We extend it to 180 the rest of the world. It has worked. And whatever has worked good, we always implemented it. Vaccination is good. Everybody gets vaccinated. Peace is good. No armies. All the armies, the assets for past 30 years in Europe is sold out. Why not extend it? If Vatican is a peace-minded thing, enforces the rest, and doesn't do what the French president said, Europe is a Catholic organization. Turkey cannot join. It's an Islamic nation. Why not Turkey and the rest to all become one? So now you have 80% of your money in your pocket. You don't mind paying 20% because the roads are clean. Your child gets educated. Your grandchild gets educated. The hospital is there if you need it. You don't abuse it. So 80% is a fair and everybody will pay. And nobody will hide the 30, 40% behind. According to the Belgian National Statistic Government, 28% of the national income is black and they cannot tax it. According to the Italian government, between 5 to 7% of GDP is in the hand of mafias, nobody pays taxes on it, and covers in reality 25 to 30% of the national income. Why not to bring mafia into the organization? You pay, you're the biggest bank in Italy, you're the biggest financiers, let people pay, you take some, we take some, it happens, the government can live. Mafia organizations under different name, here even in this state, they're very powerful, but you lot have your own mafia, Sicilians have the rest of Italy. Bolo, where we are, is the only part that the Sicilian mafias don't operate because they have a bigger, stronger mafia themselves. Am I correct? Yes? Correct. Because they share. I know too much, that's the problem. I've eaten on the table of both, in Sicily and here. So, what's going to happen? Do you pay, do you hide 30% or 28% according to the official, you don't want to do unofficial Belgian government statistics on the black. Now, you lose 43% of national income plus what you get you tax 70% of, actually the government collects 5 to 10%. 20% just, and nobody does any crime, is better than 5 to 10%. What is wrong with it? It's better for the nation, it's better for the world. I go and I say, this is my taxes, I pay my taxes. I have left my books open. You come and look, this is what I have. You don't go, this is a black, this is, you go and buy a pack of cigarettes here, would you like to pay black or would you like to pay white? I just want a cigarette to kill my wife. That's what I say. I go to the cigarette shop. And I says, can I have something to kill my wife? I said, oh, it's right here. I said, I just want a pack of Marlboro. Because at the end, they're going to kill her, but she doesn't see it. So, which way is the humanity going? I told you in the teaching of last week, you have to look into the failures to understand the failures that you can correct them. This is part of the problem of world peace. Taxation, money, how we run ourselves. But the biggest problem is a lot of you are developing your reactors. A lot of you, and I'm pushing you, one day one of you breaks and the rest will run like a rabbit behind it, because human race is a very good fucking photocopy machine. What's going to happen? Let me tell you what has happened in the space before we try to stop it here, but it's going to happen to you one way or another. 30 to 40% of the Earth educated population will leave this planet within the first 3 years. Fifty percent of this lot will never come back. This is a statistic in the universe who works, and it's very statistically correct. The other 60 to 70% which are left behind are farmers, local people, which have no interest to see the world. Half of these will go to space to see how it looks. 50% of these will never come back. So, the Earth will face a huge depopulation of the educated, of the elite, who is going to look after the sick, the old, the children of this planet. This is falls on what I call the human race to see the consequences according to what we've seen in other structures. So, what are you going to have, more or less? About 30 to 40% of you lot will stay behind, old, uneducated, and in a way, a lot of uneducated, it costs them very little money to escape the slavery of the planet. They will go to space themselves anyway, and they risk it. We see them how they've done it across the oceans, how they get on little dinky boards to get out of the poverty which is imposed on them. They will take a chance. So, your biggest population problem is very few educated to look after the rest. Very few middle age to look after the old. Japan is facing it now. And they cannot resolve the problem. The Japanese problem will be highlighted in most of the cultures around the world, but Japan is typical. Nobody speaks the language, they can't bring workers from outside, nation is becoming highly old nation, and we've seen productivity drop in the culture, in the environment, in the economy. What they've done, China went for resources, Japan is going for human resources, investing their companies, their national assets in outside countries where there is life, there is youth, there is education, and people can carry on to keep them wealthy. So what we're going to do? This is your problem as a human race, and nobody else's. Now, keep on building. I support you. I teach you. Now we brought outside help to show you how to do things, what are the consequences, how you make your shielding, how you make your systems, In 12 months time, you start flying around. First of all, there'll be mayhem on this planet because of this technology. The ones you robbed want their wealth back. The one who have the wealth will fight to keep it because it's the habit to steal. So you better find a solution for this, because a lot of people who are stolen do not know how to fight because they've been too lazy sitting there robbing. And the ones who've been stolen know exactly how to fight, and they've been working around the technology of the Keshe Foundation. They don't harm. They just take the memory of the guy off his brain that he has any wealth. You'll be amazed what you can do with this system. Or you come to an agreement, nobody touches a reactor with the blood of man and another piece in it. I can show you, all of you in this room, within 2 minutes, I can ask you to jump upside down, hang from the ceiling, and still you think you can hang on. Because through the structure of the reactors, even the material in this room, I can control your physicality. We showed it with Dr. Ilya Kostova in Christmas. I repeat it again. We stopped the reactor controlled between three nations, Germany, Canada, and here. We wished we control with it. As a center core members of the core foundation, I have that strength. So, how many of you would like to hang from a ceiling which has no ceiling and no hook? So, choice is yours. Go on the net, teach people the technology and the condition of it to bring peace. Or, we showed it on Sunday. It didn't happen somewhere else, it happened where I was sitting, and it happened right on top of my head. I didn't even move an inch to go. Because friends always come home to show their gift. So, you tell me what you want to see next. My suggestion is, let's play hangman game. Have you ever played hangman? You know what it is. But this time, the hangman is nobody dying. But we say, choose a president that he will forget he's a president. And we show him in public. Is President Obama good enough? Choose. I choose the Queen of England. She comes in, stripped naked of her own jewels and everything, she can't even remember she's a queen. You choose. We gave you a satellite choice in physicality. Now, as human population, choose a world leader. And I bring them out as a monkey. I don't do it. I show you how to do it. You bring them out as a monkey. I'm safe. You already know, in all the teachings, you know how to make a monkey out of a president and a king and a queen. The way you can make a monkey out of them to accept peace. Yesterday in the teachings, I explained this very clearly. This is the earth. You saw the disk. I explained to you, if you take it up, we touch the satellite ring. If I bring it down, I touch the human brain. I can choose. The height of the man is going to affect, the color of the man is going to affect, the language of the man is going to affect. How many blessed Germans you like to see walking around as zombies in Germany not knowing where they're going? Create a zone, 2 to 4 kilometers, nobody knows who they are. Very polite, they still go to work. But if the work is a military factory, they don't walk in because it says, peace, I don't make arms, they go home. And strange enough, they still get paid. One of the reasons we had a big problem in Brescia, where we were in the Sassano, was not the technology was getting blocked. people, the influential people, financial people, powerful people in Brescia realized what we stand for, everything became blocked. Why? Brescia is the biggest gun manufacturing city in the world. And the directors of the factory were telling us what orders is coming in. They're planning a war. We never received such an order in our life of the factory. If you produce gun, you have to use it, otherwise it's no good. So there is a plan for a bigger war. And that's why we push. Who's paying for these guns to be manufactured in Brescia in a gun factory? Biggest order even before World War II. Why such a big order has gone to such a factory to produce guns? If there is no need for it. So, the directors were not happy. The people who were there, why have we received? How many more of us? Is there going to be another war in Europe? We saw there was a plan. Ukraine was set up to agitate, to start. Core team support, we succeeded. There's a lot of guns out there that are planning where they're going to use it because the order has come in. Vatican has paid for it. Vatican sponsors most of the wars. And always is Muslims to be wrong that Vatican, the Christians, are the saviors. While keeping the Muslims busy, they rob the pockets, central banks. So, I told you, the gloves are off. We have all the knowledge. Peace is the only option because the peace on this planet is the key to universal community. And you can have whatever you like. Eric Carlson in Germany made gold out of nowhere. Mr. Hoi from China has made gold out of nowhere. I made gold out of fresh air in Tehran. We make blood here out of fresh air. All of you, you know how to do. You've done it as a knowledge seeker. All of you know how we teach you how to make three-dimensional brain which can control everything by your thoughts. Marco is busy with it. So, a brain which knows no fight, and can knows, it assumes and calculates all is working, how the move will be peaceful. In respect to all the other brains and all the other systems, will be a peaceful mind. So, the choice is yours. Choose war and we wipe you out. Choose peace and we help you out. Which way you want to go? You're going to pick Armanov. Bring him here, don't let him go home. Yeah, bring him. We haven't seen him for 3 weeks. I think he speaks Chinese, so. He ate too many noodles. Thank you very much. Tell him to come in and can go home afterwards. He won't sleep. His time is totally confused. He works in American time. He goes to China. He lives here. It's half Italian time, half American time. Lives in China. You talk to him, he's always working. Thank you very much. Thank you. So, now, what are we going to do? You came here every week trying to learn about how to make free energy, how to make tools to have materials, how to fly. Now, you've been taught everything, and the peace is the condition to achieve it. Strange enough, I tell you something, a lot of you will have a big problem with. A lot of you have a big problem with this because it's ingrained in your DNA and RNA. And that is, none of you up to now have achieved lift, motion, or energy. Do you know why? Have you ever asked your question? All these people on this planet are working and they're not achieving any of it. The reason behind it is your own fear of war. How am I going to fight? How am I going to avoid paying taxes when I have free energy? Well, how am I going to avoid doing this and that? How am I going to avoid a lot of things? You have not gained self-confidence to be trusting your own soul that I achieve lift, I enforce peace. I achieve motion, I bring peace about. I have energy, I make sure the peace comes through energy. You are all a bunch of thieves, and your soul knows. Till you don't come match, it will not click. The skin of a man is the biggest deception of the man. You deceive yourself. Because success means you'll be ridiculed. Success means you will not be able to achieve what you agreed with yourself, that I'll achieve peace through it. The enlightenment doesn't come in physicality. The enlightenment comes through the soul. And all of you have not understood the work of your own soul. Then, as I said, you control the emotion through the reactor, you control the physicality. You will fly. You will create energy. But you don't trust your own instinct because so much wrong has been done to you, you don't know what's going to be the next wrong. As is written, in my name, I can do what I like. I wonder what you do in your name. Are you wolves in the skin of a lamb? Or are you chickens who are scared even to stick your neck out and might get beaten up? The choice is very simple. Accept peace through new technology and as a universal community we gift you the knowledge. As we've done up to now. You choose. You choose the path of peace, we gift you the knowledge as we've done up to now. You choose the path of war. This time, we don't leave you alone. We force you to accept. And don't forget, a large percentage of you wear the skin of the man, but you're not from this planet. You have mutated to be here, to survive. Those will not participate in this game, because they're already on the move. It's the man who will kill the man, and it's the man who accepts the peace. Next Thursday, not here, most probably. I already told Marco and Avon will run. There is a reason I'm not here, and if we succeed in our work, then collectively with the government, will announce it. And the target for this is primarily in the background to enforce this. To show the power of the technology through the strength of the technology, reinforce peace. I keep very close counsel with the people near me like Marco and Armand. They know what I do in the background. They know why they're here for. And they know what is the purpose of this? Why I'm not here next week? That's why I wasn't here last week. Because now it's time for you to teach each other than relying on a man. If the clandestine activities of the King of Belgium would have carried out and would have succeeded last June, July, I would have been, the knowledge would have been lost. Now we are here. You can teach each other. You know everything. Read, every word said, digest it, open it up, find your own way, you can do it. From now on, I try to facilitate the process of peace, because the teaching will be done by you, amongst yourself, the way you understand. Respect should come out of knowledge and equality, and not by force. And this is what has been done by the world leaders. I have no respect for Obama. His Excellency President Obama does not deserve respect, because he has not carried out a single thing he ever asked for and he mandated himself in respect to peace. The same with the Queen of England, the same with the Pope, the same with the religious leaders across Iran and other nations. Because none of them can say we delivered peace. Now we hear. I haven't listened to the news for 6 months because it's not worth listening to. Nothing but the plan of murders behind murders. We hear Amman. I heard somebody telling me they used a nuclear bomb in Amman recently. Is it correct? I'm not bothered with it, because the kingdom of Saudi Arabia, there is no kingdom. There were a bunch of tribesmen who know nothing but killing and murdering. And who made a king out of them? A king who's on throne by mistake. Queen, English monarchy. 100 years ago, there was no Saudi kingdom. Bunch of thieves, bandits were given the title and they're hanging on to it at any cost. And now, you had Ukraine and the Vatican, now you have Shias and the Muslims at each other's throat. Financed, encouraged, in the background by the British. Chinese have nothing to do with it, Russians have nothing to do with it. Because there is a lot of money here. It's a huge amount of billions here to be spent to kill. You want to know what it is? Saudi Arabia imports, exports 6 million barrels of oil a day. Officially, unofficially, for the king's children, there is another 2.8 million. So, in fact, Saudi Arabia puts 8.8 million oil a day into the market. King, the ex-king, have a huge entourage of grandchildren. And each one is given 100,000 barrel, 500,000 barrel every month to spend to keep quiet. They don't threaten the kingdom. Total export, round about 8.5. Don't tell me how I know. I can show you. I used to be in that business. I made my first million out of Saudi family. Now, forget about this. This is spending casinos and on Russian girls. You never see it. 8 million. 6 million a day. $100 a barrel. That is $600 million grow out of earth. Earth, as I call shitting money. The money is kept Swiss bank in the name of Rothschild. Rothschilds connected directly by descent to the King of Belgium and English royal family. So everything ends up in their hands. But for every $100, don't ask me, I used to be in this game, if you want I'll bring you documents to see. We make up to $10,000 per barrel on average, byproducts. 40 to 50,000 minimum byproducts from oil. Now, my dearest friends, that is an income every day for one nation. Saudi Arabia has got its chemical processing plants. Saudi Arabia has got all its refining processes. All the money stays in the families. Now, look at the bigger picture. This is daily oil production of Russia, China, Saudi Arabia, and the rest put together. Again, and again. $70 billion a day added to assets, which is God-given from the earth. And all of you now, you learn how to produce this at home in your CO2 gas. So, this money has to be spent somewhere. War game. Who's more powerful? Is power play, money doesn't count into it anymore. Because, unfortunately, you have another problem which adds to this. Let's say, roughly, $365 days. Let's call it $350 days. Three times that is 25. Now, you see the game. And all the billions. It's a huge amount of money. And strange enough, most of people who do this have cancer, the family is dying, and they have all sorts of complications. They can't eat more than one steak a day. Where is this money going? Instead of supporting humanity for peace, it's used for a tool of war. Let's see how they kill each other. Let's see, I rape a child, how he squeaks before he dies. King of Belgium, 50 cases of murder sitting in France, political immunity. A murderer shouldn't have a political immunity raping children. Who is supporting these people? Why we let animals in the name of human being roam amongst us? Amongst you, nothing to do with me. Somebody told me I'm an alien. When they tested my blood for poisoning, what did she say? He's an alien. He should be glowing, but I don't know how he's got a human body. So, now you see what is driving all the wars. What about if we use these facilities, finances, which is temporarily to buy a house, build a house for every man, give them a CO2 gas system, feed them. We'll gain more blessing than killing them. That's the purpose of the religious, is to get the blessing for the prophet they are appointed for, not more murders. As I said, and I say it again, with what they are doing in the name of religion, they're reducing the level of the soul of their prophet. Because he's paying with his soul, not with theirs. What they've done in the name of Christianity as a pope is done nothing, all of them, but bringing the level of the soul of the Christ down, because he is responsible for their conduct. If Christians knew what they are doing to what they pray to, they will destroy Vatican and all the churches. Because, as the famous American president said before he resigned, the buck stops here. I'm on the top. You remember? There'll be no whitewash in the White House. You remember? Who said it? Nixon? Watergate? He says the buck stops here. The buck of all the murders done in the name of God by all these religious leaders, be it Muhammad, be it Christ, be it Moses, stops at the soul of Christ, at the soul of Moses and the rest. So if you are praying to give to him, why you're diminishing him? Has anybody taught you the ethics of the work? You don't even understand what you're doing. You go to church, you pay your money to the mosque, they buy guns, they kill in the name of the religion. Because the religious people do it, they are responsible, they are linked, and done through their prophets. You don't want to know the state of the soul of Christ with all the crimes done by Vatican and the rest of the Christians as crusaders. Forget about the Muslims and Sikh and Hindus. You don't want to know those either. Let's go to Vatican, let's go to the mullahs and the ayatollahs and the rest and say, what was the level of the Christ before you become a pope or the leader, and what is it today? How many people you killed? How much is given from his soul? Started from 100, today is 0. Because everything affects, he is responsible. The soul of Christ is responsible. Read my writing. Not in my time, not one is my watch. How many times have I stated this? Means I do not give from my soul for no one to harm. So I teach you not to harm each other. So I don't lose from my soul. Because when the Christ, blessed his name, accepted the position as a prophet, he accepted with his soul, not with his physicality. So he pays through his. And the Vatican encourages more murder, more financing. Who's paying for it? If you're a religious person, you ask them. Then, are the religions, all the world leaderships the same? Of course. How many promises the world leaders give us when they get into power, they can't do it. It was a good way to get. The biggest one, the first day, the instant Obama came into power, was the prison in Cuba. He signed, he will close it. 8 years later down the line, we're still there. But he gave the promise, he raised the hope in the soul of the families. He's taking it from them. He pays with his soul because he dictated the condition. Ask yourself, now it's opening into the space technology, is it worth to start another war even in a space? Because who's going to pay for it? You. Where is, at the moment, the state of the soul of a Christ, that's his name, or Muhammad, with the wars which are going, financed by the Christians, by the Muslim, and the Jews, and the rest? Zero. You've taken everything. You demolished everything in the name of a bunch of greed, pedophiles, and thieves in the churches, in the mosques, and in the rabbis, and the rest of it. They are not short of each other. Believe you me, I can tell you so much of it. You want to know? Go to Sikhs, and Hindus, and Buddhists. They are worse. They're all called Pedophile Club. Then you know the rest of it. I'm not afraid of my life because my life is beyond their touch. But what I'm afraid of is a single soul to be attacked or damaged under my watch, under my agreement. And it will not happen. You can harm yourself, but not under my name. So, understand this, I work and I will achieve my mandate. Because I know where the man will go. And now I showed it to you in the video, and I show it to you again and again. We brought reinforcement in. Peaceful reinforcement. You saw it in that video. I explained to you the technology. I showed you how to make it, explained in detail yesterday. Now, Do you enforce peace? Not mine anymore. The knowledge is transferred. The check is drawn. You cashed it. Now is the responsibility of your souls, not mine. And ask the world religious leaders and the world leaders. Two questions. What's the position of the soul of Christ, Muhammad, and other world leaders, religious leaders, by the crimes you committed because he accepted you, you're talking on his behalf. And then ask your world leaders, who's responsible for the souls which you have murdered? On the name of arms, defense, women, whatever you like. A child, life, gets raped by the king of Belgium, and a soldier which gets killed in Amman or in conflict has no difference. It's all stealing. And that was the first rule and the only rule of the universe. Thou shalt not steal. So, as I said, we start the peace process, we gave you the tools, now we show you the consequences. If you come here to learn about the plasma and you say the guy preaches, my friend, you're a thief, that you want to rob, but the excuses, I've come to learn how to rob. To learn to fly, to learn to create energy, become straight with your own soul, and then you achieve your dream. One of you, amongst you, is one of us. I explained that yesterday. And then, he sets the scene without you knowing that you follow. You follow. Human beings are like sheep. Wherever the first one goes, the rest go. Oh, he managed to create a reactor with the guns. Oh, we do all the guns. What about the guns and the gas? Oh, let's try. You're so desperate that you don't stand still. We have everything. Let's do it logically. Let's look at what we want. Do you want a matter state or do you want an energy state? You want, I told you, as I tell you, I just said, you have matter, you have GANS, you have nanomaterials, you have plasma, and you have a gas. What do you want in what state of the plasma, in what strength? You want hard material to construct. You want the energy of flight system. You want a material that does the construction and can jump between the two. You've seen it. You condition it, goes back. Or you want to bring it in a state of a gas. That is one of the conditions of the universe, free plasma, which takes the shape of its container. None of you has ever understood why I call the GANS gas in a nano state. I don't understand. Gas, single atom of gas, fills in the shape of its container. Now you have made it to a plasma of it. Do you know what power you're sitting on? Do you understand the implication? A GANS, you see here, in this room, you have a GANS in a cup. And then you miss the other side. Gas takes the shape of its container. How have you managed to bring this into this? What it gives you? And what about if you take this to his? Have you ever heard of potential difference? Have you ever understood what you're talking about? Do you know how much energy is in there to do? You're so busy with other rubbish to satisfy your own ego, you don't even understand. You see them. Gases in nanostate. Understood this, and you'll be sitting in all the teachings for past months. Because you're so focused to rob and not to get robbed by the governments that you're robbing from yourself. So the thief sits in the house, not outside. Do you understand? You capture a CO2, which is free in the environment, you put it in a glass. That CO2, according to the law of physics, can take the shape of its container. You make it a container. You contain it. But what happened to this energy? We don't understand, so we ignore it. Now you have to understand. You have no choice because now it's sitting in front of you. Scientists, we have Dan Winter online watching. If he understood what I said with the knowledge he has about the plasma, he will commit suicide, how much he's missed. But I presume he hasn't understood. Even though I have so much respect for his work, but he still don't see the totality. Try to understand one simple thing. If you do not steal from yourself, too busy to steal from your own soul, you will see the light. You will fly. And if it's your intention pure enough, you can fly physically without needing a craft. Because it's within your structure. A lot of you have missed a very, very, very big point. The biggest space reactor is your own body. Why are you trying to build another one to move in it? You understand? You lot, go and create a GANS. Few drop of this, you put it, a gram of it in the reactor to make it dynamic. By God, it's 60 kilogram of this sits in your body. What are you doing with it? How much energy is sitting in there in a plasma condition? You're hoping to fly with a gram of this. What about 60,000 gram of this, which you're not using? You're so greedy to get, you forget what you've got. Do you need to create a CO2? Have you ever listened to what I said? Your body is made of GANS. You go to make a few grams of this, extract your own blood, how many liters, how many reactors do you want to do? And the more you bleed, the more you make. But you have to understand that you make a condition that the GANS of the blood stays in the GANS state. What does that mean? You make a reactor which is nano-coated. You were looking to have three different layers of material. My friends, you already have four materials in your GANS, plus all the minerals which is in it in the GANS state. Your reactor will not make one shielding, it makes millions of shielding. But you got to know how to anticipate it, how to force it, how to release it, where you want to do it. If you understand it, use your brain, all of you will be floating. But you're too busy with 1 kilowatt of energy free, you got billions of kilowatts in your hand. Habit of thieving and stealing is part of your nature. Even you steal from yourself. So, The situation is very simple. As a knowledge seekers, as a people who understand the world peace, you start working for world peace that the next generation will not fall in the hand of abusers, but them knowing the reality they cannot be abused. And then you start working the path of peace. You will think of it, you eat it, you believe it, and you work on it. I said to a guy very recently, if you change the churches which are in this country to the places to teach about the soul in the way it works through the GANs, do you think we need any more churches? Or did they become the educational center for the correct conduct? One point which is important for you, and in a way is irrelevant for me, is who have you sold your soul to? Because if you understood the work of the reactors, the soul collects, dictates the physicality. And the bus where you sold it dictates your behavior. In English, they say, you have sold your soul to the devil. And do you know who came up with this? The church. Because the devil sits in the house of God. Because he encourages war, conflict, adultery, and everything else. Because that's way is the only way which makes money. But it has made you to accept it as your fault that he can do. Change the name, synagogue. Change the name to a mosque. Change the name to a temple. It's all the same. The more I encourage you to do crime, the more money I make you, because you come to tell me what your physicality has done, I control your soul. So, if you can answer that, you find your path to peace. Go today, forget about CO2, forget about anything else. Create a nano-coated reactor inside as a ball. Make sure you use a nano-coated tube. Transfer your blood into the reactor without touching physicality of the earth, because it goes from one gas state to another, and then you see whose emotion you can control. And I advise you one thing, please, as I said to the core team in respect to His Excellency President Putin, make your concentration on this guy. Because if the Pope pops, the rest of the universe will be at peace. Same with any other religious leaders. Understand something very, very clear. I was explaining this last night to my son. We are here because of the abuse and killing and the murder by the King of Belgium on scientists and the children. That's where he makes his pleasure and his money from. Pleasure out of children he rapes, money out of the scientists who he sells his knowledge from. And then ask yourself one question. Why are we here? Why have we ended up in Italy? Because his masters sit in Italy. And they protect us to see the end to their process. The story of Moses and the king. I was their biggest nightmare, and I'm here now. I want to know how they're going to handle it. We talk peace through the church and the mosque, or we give more money and more blood for more abuse. But the question is, are you going to stand any more of this abuse? That means you're used to abuse, you enjoy the abuse. Or you're going to change the position. Let the world people know what the technology is, what the knowledge is, and what is the consequence of accepting and delivering the knowledge. In the coming weeks, we should have the message from China too. We release a press conference, live from this room, to show a new energy system. It's not done by me, it's done by the Keshe Foundation support. More or less, we revolutionize the energy market. It's arranged by them. I'm just a watcher. You've been waiting for, you will receive it. And it'll be done in the international press conference. That's what they tell me they are going to do. They are setting the factories to make sure everybody gets whatever is possible. And as the Keshe Foundation intercourse, they release it. We can only furnish 10, 20, 100 million. There is 7 billion of human beings on this planet. Needs a lot of factories around the world to do. Patent open. Knowledge shared, because we know by sharing the knowledge, we have peace. No one will go over the others. So, ethical, connected to scientific, and enforcement of science. All depends on you, how you're going to do it, the way you like to do it, and the way you see a path out of it. In the coming time, we shall see the world leaders and the kings will take the crown off their head, because they don't want to lose, not from their physicality, but from the status of their soul. That's if they understand what they are doing. Or they change the tune from war to peace. Because some of them are still in the same trap as Mr. Noble, trying at least to get something back, even if it's in the physical world, in their other dimension. So, the position is very simple. You came here for 63 weeks to steal from me knowledge that you can steal from your nation. Today is the 64th. 63 was 9. 64 is 10, is the beginning. Now, I've given you everything, is the beginning. Use it from today to achieve peace. You have stolen everything from me as a knowledge, one form of another. Be the king, be the man on the street, in Africa, in New Orleans, or in China. Now, use this, what you have stolen from yourself, because don't forget, in my name, I cannot steal. So, use the knowledge, use the understanding to enlighten the others not to accept peace because it gives them a free energy source or free space travel. But that the consequence of peace is totality of not harming another single soul. And if they can understand this, you have already achieved peace. In English, and we have it in the Farsi too, we say, drop, drop, it makes an ocean. Every single soul understands, adds to the strength of the peace. If they understand it, but they don't join it to have the reactor. As we've seen, people come and says, I have come here to understand the plasma, not religious or ethical talks. It means I'm a thief. Give it to me, I want to steal more. So if I give you a car and I don't teach you how you're going to damage yourself, then I'm responsible, not you. You're an idiot, it's your problem. I have to watch, my teaching becomes idiot-proof. So, those of you who are here for the purpose of serving mankind for one direction and don't join the religious and government of the past and the present, start acting and delivering the world peace, not just by paper, but to teach. But to understand what it means this time. We are not another Greenpeace paid by the Russians during the Cold War and now paid by the Americans during the Hot War. It's the same Greenpeace, the same people. They who were pays, they follow the master. I call Greenpeace open prostitution in the name of government. In bed with whoever pays. Russian paid for a long time to push the nuclear technology. We knew, when I was a nuclear student at the time, we knew how they were getting their money, how they were getting supported. Why did they never go into the Russian submarine region to start causing problems? Greenpeace was all nuclear to do with the West. And they say, we are an ethical organization, our bank account is transparent. My foot. You don't want to know the bank accounts we knew in the background, which was paying everything, in suitcases, black. And now, the Americans pay, the same people, they're going against the Russians and everybody else, and the Japanese, and the rest. I said to a world leader, Greenpeace is green piss. That's all they've done. They pissed on what they like, and if they enjoy the smell, they accepted it. I had a lot of tackle with these people when I was a nuclear physicist, nuclear engineer. We were the target, threatened, all sorts of things. You are murderers. I said, can I see Russian bank account? I work on my own. I said, who paid your bill to come here? Who brought you with the transport? Who paid for the fuel? So, try to understand the principle of the technology, not blindly, through your soul, through understanding of its operation, is the operation of your physicality. Then you find your physicality at peace, then you will live a peaceful life, and then you create a peaceful world. And with it, you have a jackpot. We take you into space, to universal family. Until all of you are not the same, nothing will happen. Because you need one stupid guy to unplug the whole boat. Two choices. Start working with the reactors filled with your own blood, and you see how it works. It works beautifully. But I hope when you fill it up, you don't have a cancer cell in it. Because you give the cancer to the rest of the people too. You just don't transfer a little bit, you transfer the totality. Those who are planning, get their blood tested fully. don't do what Freddie Mercury did. We all know who Freddie Mercury is. The Queen, the band Queen. He was one of the biggest murderers ever known. That man was the biggest criminal. And everybody sings his songs. I want to be free. He put a lot of souls in prison. Freddie Mercury, when he found out he has AIDS, he went to Munich, and by the time he realized, till the day he died, he deliberately, according to the German government, infected over 2,500 boys for them to suffer, for them to die, because who gave it to me, I give it to everyone. One single man, plus go by the ratio of the AIDS homosexuality around the world, how many of these 2,500 infected? One man single-handedly put millions of families, young boys, and the rest in huge problems. That guy should have never been born. He was free before he was born. He put a lot of people in jail. How many parents lost their children? How many fathers got AIDS and couldn't see their children to be grown up? I told you, amongst you as men, you are the weakest and you claim to be the best. And you sing his song. His records should be burned. His name should be erased from the human race, because if man knew what this murderer has done, go to German government, read the statistics what he did. He went to Munich in the Gay World Center and infected anybody who wanted to be infected, because anybody would like to be sleeping with Mary Mercury. And he died the best way, the most horrible life, his soul dictated on his physicality. So, understand one single rule. Would you like to be the one man who taught so many people for their souls to be free? Or you want to be the man who allows so many holes to go down the path the rest of them? As they say, the choice is yours. You choose, nobody else. Your wife doesn't decide, your son doesn't decide, your brother doesn't decide. It's you who chooses. You choose the path of peace through the new technology, new science, teach it, show it, enjoy the pleasure of a new chance to be given a second chance to live a good life, or go and do the rest. No problem. I met one of Americans, as I said last week, last Thursday, governors, ex-governors, advisor to His Excellency President Obama, he says. I said, he knows. Tell him what's the answer for the roadmap I put out today. Still waiting. How many of you have taken the message to the White House? An Iranian guy took the peace message last time to the White House. He knows who he is. And he received a letter back from the White House. And we published the letter. Officially cannot be on the letterhead of the White House with the little, the White House, but it's on the private letter of the House, by, signed by Obama, written by him, justifying how he kills. If the soul of Christ is there, paying for his people, imagine the soul of a man who knows how he's organizing murders. In the name of the President, the most powerful man. I think to me, people in the White House, the weakest people, get that place, because they do what they are told. If you're strong, you dictate your position. Peace, we go, we do, we find a solution. None of it. I've seen one man in my lifetime, and he is forgotten because we chose to, and it's, we know who he is. Mikhail Gorbachev. his nation was bigger than him to be free. And he accepted the wall to come down. The Americans wrote, as I said, on Munich, mission accomplished. Yes, mission accomplished in failing. Gorbachev is the man who achieved more than anybody else for peace. Because he put the priority of his nation, his people, over him to be called the president. At his position, he would have never been replaced. He would have been the most powerful man in the world as the head of Russian state. He walked away from it. Because the presidential name did not justify a single man to be shot on the wall in Berlin. He could have said, shoot, we're all there. We're all, it's our lifetime. If he would have given the instruction to shoot over the wall, don't come down, he would have still been the president, most probably more powerful than the Americans. He did not accept to endanger a single soul. I call the president, I don't need it. And last Thursday, I was supposed to meet him. He's sick. That's why I went to Rome. So now you know how we work in the background for the purpose of peace. World leaders know who we are, world leaders know how we behave, world leaders know, and the people who are involved in the affair of world peace know how to put men of the same mentality together. So, you have two choices. Peace or war. War, now you know the truth with yourself, in your structure, in your body, or peace amongst the man, which is you and you only. When you're at peace with yourself, you create a peaceful environment. So, now, let's talk about how to kill each other. See how well you listen. Because whatever I said this morning has gone over your head. It's nothing to do with you. You're too small to make a difference, and peace has nothing to do with you. You still would like to pay 70% taxes and complain about your government, where you can pay 20% taxes and live a beautiful life. All the ones who say we pay 70% taxes, 65% taxes, and they don't accept 20, you must be all idiots. All of you. A fool does this. Now, kill yourself three reactors. Let's see how you can kill yourself. And see if why you came here is not this, but is this. And let's speak about the plasma. Your plasma works in a very beautiful way. Your plasma creates fields that in the interaction of the fields, you create a field here. All of you who have started reactors, you always start four together. It's wrong. Don't do it. Start the one triangle formation first. Two sides, one top, three bottoms, two sides, because it's still three. If you do your calculation right, everything has to be equal distance in all directions. So either way you look at your reactor, you have three sets. Always start with three you feel comfortable with. Pray for it, you create a soul. Allow it to grow, that it finds balance between all three. Be a Jewish guy, not a Muslim guy. You know the difference. I've explained this very much, many times. You stand outside somewhere, I've done it, it's fantastic if you understand it. You stand outside and watch a Jewish man and a Muslim man go to the toilet together. You time. Within 5 seconds, the Muslim man is out, go to the market, I have to sell. Physically, I have to do something. The Jewish guy sits in the toilet for half an hour. He thinks, he takes his time. He walks out, the Muslim guy works for a whole year, 200,000 euro. The Jewish guy by afternoon has already earned 10,000 because he thinks his way. He just doesn't plow in. So, take your time. Yes, your reactors, your plasma to mature. What you do in your reactors, it takes a million years to be done, minimum, in the process of the universe. You lot are quit action. No, in, out, done. Take your time. Let the reactor build its place. Let it find peace with itself. Because at the first instant, all of it, they're all putting something in. He has to find out each one how much he has to give, how much he has to take, how much he can hold without damaging the others. It doesn't happen. My reactor stopped going, blah. And all of you have seen doing it. And I watch it because I always say, I don't do it this way. When I built the energy reactor, the brass one, it took me nearly 3 months to coat it. It was sat in a pot in my lap, and I watched it every day because I know the more layers I created in the structure, the more detached I became from physicality. I could operate more in the environment of universe. But you lot come in, this become a rat race and I don't say anything. I said, yes, we found a very good way to create nanomaterial, electricity. Find a better way to create a nanomaterial. Ask yourself, half-cooked jobs, you create nanomaterials which are not positioned the right way. They are not created the correct way. It's mishmash of layers wanting to be freed. You're actually doing exactly what humans do. Imprison whatever you can to get what you want. Needs time. How many times, if you listen to my teaching, I call it velvetish feeling. You see it. You see the freedom of the atom. You enjoy seeing it. And I keep on telling you, don't touch it, because when you touch it, you crush it, you destroy it. Do the same thing with your reactors. Take time. Go for a coffee. Go for a weekend holiday. Let them find peace. When they're at peace, when you bring another reactor, go for another holiday. Let the balance comes. How many times have we done in the reactors in the lab? We leave them, whatever I say. Just leave it for days and days till it matures. Always do. Leave it. 2, 3 days, 4 days, you start seeing the result. Because fields have to find out not only the balance between themselves, with the other reactors as well. It's consultation. Guys, we want to move from this position to center. Anybody wants to give any? Anybody who's got anything to participate? Anybody needs some? I have some to give. 129 Tesla. Anybody take? Take time to reduce GANs. Because a GANs has a soul, has a direction, has an involvement with the other GANs inside the container. Treat me good, I serve you good. I have reactors now running for what, 4 years now, 5 years? I don't even go and see them. Because I know I have to wait between 10 to 15 years before I see what I'm waiting for. It's like making wine, you have to let it to mature. You lot don't have time. I have a yellow box. You've seen it, I've shown it. Four reactors in there, doing their own work. I know maybe 10 to 15 years, I might see something which has taken 10 million years on this planet. Creation with arms and legs. I set it up that way, that it can make a decision the correct way. You've seen how many are in the box. Have you seen how they're positioned in the box? Because you look at the box, the four inside it, I look at the planet Earth, which is the box itself, to me is one. How they interact with each other inside is different. I've seen things crawling, moving on the top, and then they're not there a few months later. Where have they gone? I see formations. Where do they go? Why do they change position? They make the decision. So when you start building your reactors, take time coating them. Take time assembling them. Take time building them. Because once you coated them, they are nanomaterials, so they are creating their own fields with their environment. Then you put another one, they are there. Take time, allow, they find the just and peace with themselves. And then you have the rest. Remember what I keep on saying in our teachings. In the matter state, what you've been taught is what we said yesterday. You have very easy, aware the tie sometimes, you see it. Circles and things and connection, double bond, single bond, one electron share, two electrons hanging, whatever. Because this is what you understand. In plasma, everything sits in the same structure. But everything has its own balance too. So this is the oxygen, and this is the carbon or hydrogen. Depends what's in your body. You look in a matter state this way, in plasma state this way. As we always said, whatever we teach during the week, we don't from the beginning, we try to cover sometimes on Thursdays. So now you understand the difference between the matter state and the plasma state. It's totally different. That gives you center mass. This gives you control. This is already controlled by conditions of its environment. Here you accommodate other things. Here you are forced to accept conditions. atmosphere pressure, atmospheric temperature dictates conditions. So if you understand this, and you create it in your reactors, don't look at this structure of matter, you're dealing with this structure. So if you have your human blood, you are not only creating the plasma of a carbon, same time the strength of the oxygen. So your core is multiple facet, energy, magnetic field strength composition. And then, as we explain, and if you understood from the structure of the plasma, the more you give, the more we take. This is a repeat for knowledge seekers, but people outside have to understand this. This is the energy of a hydrogen. Here is the energy of a carbon. Here is less of, here is more of. And then the more you go to the center of a plasma, the stronger it gets. Because plasma is inversely gravitational magnetic field strength. If you understood this, then you understand this, then you understand if, how you give, you take from here 1 Tesla, you take from here 100 Tesla. Here you get 10 to the power of 4, here you get 10 to the power of 8. Understand what this means, that's 10 to the power of 2. 1 times energy of a neutron, 100 times energy of a neutron, 10,000 times energy of a neutron, 100 million times energy of a neutron. That is why when you change gans into the matter, you have number of electrons and protons according to the mass of his plasma. That's why fusion, the way it's spoken about, does not exist. Because universe does not fuse atoms together. Universe releases packages of plasma, which this package fits to copper, and the other package keeps into plutonium. So in that environment you get this, in this environment you get this. And this is the reason, as we said before, you don't find all the state of matter in all places in the universe. At the present physics teaching, which is totally wrong, it says number of huge hydrogens collide and fuse, and then they give you copper. That's why helium and the present fusion technology is pushing for, fusing together. There is no fusion. As I said before, you've seen glass of water on the table. Whatever you get bubbles of it, that's what it is. That's exactly the work of the universe. And if you understood this, and you understand this, then you understand how to take energy of a hydrogen, you call it at 20 Tesla, and then you go to the energy of, let's say, 10 to the 4 or 125 Tesla, you get the energy of plutonium. So we don't do anything. We just peel the skin of the onion, layer by layer. The stronger, the further you go inside. Understand one thing. I explain this to children when I teach them about plasma. And this is because they can see it. Go home, get the onion, and cut the onion right across. Right in the center. That's the shape of the onion. You see layers by layers by layers by layers. The center is the center of the principal matter. And the plasma goes by layer according to its strength. That's exactly what onion is. Onion is another solar system. As the layer decides, the leaf, next layer. and then the next layer. There's no difference between the structure of an onion and a solar system and a plasma of a sun. You ask, you go on internet, look at the structure of the plasma of the sun. This is what you get, an onion. And the peel outside is the crust. Then the center sits, the center energy, because it has enough power to push the others out to grow. There is more power in the little one in the center than actually the whole skin outside. Because it has given away, it has created the space, so it's enough power inside to push open. If you understand this, then you understand you can fly anywhere in the universe because you can create both gravitational and magnetical field of any destination in the universe. Depends on which layer of onion you choose your thing. This was 1 Tesla. This is 1,000 Tesla. The other one is 10,000,000 Tesla. So, understand this, run your reactors, now mix with your blood, you find one of the most powerful systems, not only controls the physicality, but it controls the emotion too. Then go and say to her, I love you. She won't trust you. But because you have used the onion principle, you touch the soul. She believes you. Then you don't need the disc to put your tea on it. What you showed me, it explains so much about human physicality that is amazing. You brought me a gift, and I thank you for it. Because it shows how us as humans relate ourselves to weakness of what we need, and we don't talk about it. It is so important to understand the structure. If you understand the process, you don't need to replicate. Because every time you make a new one, you understand it however. I think it's good enough for one day. Are there any questions?
Can you hear me okay, Mr. Keshe?
I cannot hear you.
Can you hear me okay now?
Oh, yes, I can hear you.
Okay, so I don't see too many questions on the GoToWebinar, and there's been lots of chatter on the live stream. We have lots of viewers today, so thank you for all your teachings today. Is Mike still available, Rick? Do you know?
Let me correct Kevin Devana. He's a Parsi. He was an Iranian. He comes from Indian background. Okay, what's the question?
I'm not clear, Vince, if Mike is still on the group here or not. I think I was told that he was fading earlier, so I suspect he may have dropped.
Okay, Mike, so no, it looks like there's
Dan Winter with us.
Yeah, he dropped off just a little bit ago.
He says Andy Ross says he's sick, so he's gone to bed.
Ah, okay.
So we wish him a very good time in his soul travel.
Yes. So we had those people are kind of teed up for earlier, but it just gets to be in a too long of a time and or time crunch for them. Okay. So what else we got there, Vince?
I think we touched a lot of people's soul. That's why they don't have any questions to ask.
Yes, they came armed with certain reactor questions, and just wasn't quite appropriate for trying to get an elbow in there in this particular case. So it's just a different topic today. There was a question that maybe I can get in if it is an actual reactor type question. I'll have to get it again here just a second. It was in the forum actually, and it's in regard to the it's Erundik. I don't know the actual person. Erundik, I think, is the name. Anyway, it's a question because he got confused today. I tried to return the CO2 GANs into the nano state black using white wine vinegar. To my surprise, the CO2 GANs dissolved totally. What happened? I thought the GANs cannot be dissolved at all. I also tried the blue CuO GANs, and the result was the same. Everything gone.
Okay, I'll tell you why you get that. You don't have a CO2 GANs. You have a nickel oxide.
Or you mean zinc oxide, perhaps.
You have wired your system the wrong way. When your current or your salt solution is not the correct way, you find out you produce nickel oxide and not a GANs material. Nickel oxide is a
matter. Do you mean zinc oxide, Mr. Keshe, or nickel oxide?
Pardon?
You mean zinc oxide, I think. Okay, just to be clear, thank you.
Yeah. So what it is, we know this for a long time, and some of the time, when you have a lot of white stuff, and then when you add vinegar, you don't get that many black stuff, which means you have created what you call it, nickel oxide. This happened.
Zinc.
Stop process, zinc oxide, sorry, yeah. To stop this process, the new CO2 kits, which are coming out of China, I've just seen a prototype, you might see one very shortly, is that because you put your material like this, a nano coated there and a zinc there, sometimes the current flow creates plating condition and you create a zinc oxide. The new systems have a facility that the plates sit outside. Whatever you produce is only CO2. We've taken this factor out. I hope Armand will bring a sample with him that we can see. So we know this with the Italian Nuclear Center when we did this, it came out. We have to understand it. Tests show nickel oxide. But if you bring the condition that only you deal with a magnetic field of the plasma, then you only create CO2, and you see different kind of pattern. But if you put your plates inside, which most of you do, if the current flow is above certain level according to your salinity, you find out the what you call a nickel oxide takes priority, and the condition for the CO2 is not getting created. So when you put the vinegar in it, you see it disappearing because it's a matter state. It's very much when you have a calcium in your pipes, in your shower head, it just dissolves it.
I think you also mentioned calcium in, it could be in people's water that they use as well, and that could show up, and that could be calcium GANs instead.
It appears at CaCO3. We know this. We've got a full report on this, and we use part of this property at the moment in Fukushima, because the Japanese water has huge content of calcium, and it allows us to function to link up the calcium that doesn't clog up the system. If you look at the reports from Fukushima, they have built a huge plant that the GANs has to go, what do you call it, the radioactive material has to go through it, and all has come to a halt. Millions of dollars of investment because of the high level of the calcium. the process which we have slightly adopted for the Fukushima allows this calcium to get out of the water. That allows the second part of the radiation process to absorb the radioactive material from the water. We know this with our work with the Italian Nuclear Center and with our work with the Fukushima scientists in TEPCO. So, this should be resolved. So,
thank you.
Put it in. If the field strength is strong enough, and then you'll find out when you do the plates outside, you say, I get no CO2. Then you have to start playing with your salt salinity.
Right. I was going to ask Mr. Keshe, what I know it was recommended at one point up to 20 and 25%, but I think now the recommendation is more around 10% for most experiments. Is that true?
It all depends on what kind of water you use. If you have a lot of calcium, some waters have zinc in them, some waters have gold in them. It's the resistance which is created in the transformation of the field. Because if you have gold content, even in 10%, then it's like cancer. It absorbs, because of its gravitational magnetic field strength, absorbs most of the energy. You never need to produce CO2. If you produce CO2 in a container inside, you might get, let's say, 10,000 nano. If you produce this way and you produce 1 million, is guaranteed. Because it's only in the condition of gravitational magnetic field of the nanomaterial. It's a very simple process, but the new systems coming out are six walls like this. And you have an option. If you want to make like copper oxide, you put your copper inside because you need the material to convert. If you want to create CO2, you put your zinc and your copper outside the box. So because for different technologies, different applications, you want different cancers, the new sets which is getting manufactured in the next 30-60 days, Rahel can tell us, is it's done this way, because I've seen the prototype. I was talking to Armin and Soher a couple of days ago. They showed it to me online. Then it depends what you want. You change the parameters, or you create a new condition where you put nickel and copper, copper and nickel, inside, outside. Then you get a combination. You have a nickel oxide, you have a zinc oxide here, you have copper here, you have iron there. So you start playing, producing new kind of gas materials, which is extension to the knowledge, and it will allow more and more to be created at a point of need. You can change it. Here you create, let's say, gravitational field of zinc. Here you create gravitational field of another material. Ooh, our Chinese friend has arrived. Good morning. Welcome home. Congratulations. Long, long way to come home. How are you? No, very good. Very, very good. Welcome, old man. Our Chinese guy has arrived. You see, Americans always arrive late. Okay. So we see the interaction and the work as you want to know. Armin, have you got the... He's just learning. Have you got the new toolkit? Pardon? No, no. They wanted the new CO2 kit you done. Okay. Oh, it's okay. We show them the real thing when we go to, what do you call it? What is the time?
10 minutes to 12. 3 minutes.
3 minutes.
Welcome back, Armin.
He says thank you, but he speaks with a Chinese accent.
He's going to miss the Chinese noodles.
He says thank you, Vince. he wants noodles. Have you brought any noodles for him? No, Vince, you have no noodles.
No noodles, okay.
No noodles, not this time. Okay, since one should clean oneself of both physical and emotional problems before making such a reactor with blood in them. My God, you have a long way coming to do that. If there are no other questions, are there anywhere in the background, anywhere else? Because I only see the teaching room.
Yeah, I don't see anything on live stream.
That's fantastic. I think we have silenced a lot of people's questions. Now they're questioning their own souls and their own ethics. Shall we call it the day we started? We've been on for how long? 3 hours nearly?
3:10, yep. 3 hours, 10 minutes.
Yes, you've been going pretty steadily there, Mr. Keshe, as well, so.
Okay.
Thank you for that.
Thank you very much indeed. I hope please give the world peace roadmap to as many people as you like, plus the world peace document for them to sign, and then if they need, still give them the world peace treaty, and we see how and where we can go further. We answer any questions this afternoon, if there are any. If there's no question, so we call it the day tomorrow early or today early. Is that okay with you guys?
You want to, you mean not to have the afternoon session? Is that what you're...
No. Afternoon session. I have few people here that kill me if they're not, especially Dr. Antonio comes all the way. Maybe we get him to explain to us his reactor. Is it flying yet? Has he loaded yet? You are supposed to be his teacher. Can you explain to us what he's doing? You're the mentor. Oh, you're doing the coating of the reactor. When would it be finished? Next week? No, so you're starting again. Now we've got to stop this 6 o'clock business here. Okay, no problem. So, this afternoon we get Marco to explain. He stopped sharing your cook. He's got fortune cookies. He's showing it under the table. What I brought from China. Look at this. You come late and you're still disturbed too. Thank you very much. We have a nice day. We'll see you later on. Bye. Thanks, Vince. Thanks, Rick.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Keshe.
Okay.
Okay. So ends the 64th Knowledge Seekers Workshop for Thursday, June 4th, 2015. And thank you, everybody, for attending.